here is a story that I think will make a lot of sense. So the more you delve into the world of the ancient mythologies of India, the more you will find it's like a treasure trove. And each story has quite an incredible message or a philosophy contained in it. So here's one that's extremely little known. It's a lesser known story, and I think you'll enjoy this. King Sagar of the Suryavansh dynasty, of the Sun dynasty. King Sagar dies very suddenly, and he leaves behind two widows who mourn him for a certain period of time. And then the monsoons come. And there's this lovely story about how the two of them go off and they have their bath, they get dressed, and they come out. And for some reason, I guess it's the monsoons, the clouds outside, those lovely sudden scented breezes blowing through the gardens. The two of them are overcome with love for each other. And the story says that they actually make love to each other. And of this lovemaking, a child is born. The child, however, is born without any bones, because in old Hindu mythology, it was believed that from the father came your skeleton, or the hard stuff inside you, and from the mother came your organs and your flesh, or the soft stuff inside you. So this little boy that is born to them is born without any bones at all. He's just born as a lump of flesh. And he grows up sort of learning how to crawl around from one place to another, you know, pull himself around as this lump of flesh from one place to another, till one day he runs into a very angry old sage. This angry old sage is actually crippled, and he walks with a limp and he hobbles along. And he looks at this young boy crawling along, and he thinks that this young boy is making fun of him. And he gets extremely angry with him, and he puts a curse on him, and he says, "You've tried to make fun of me by copying my disability. I am going to put a curse on you." And this young boy says, no, I haven't been trying to make fun of you, but this is me. I was born without any bones. I can't stand up on my two feet. I have to crawl around." And the sage doesn't quite believe him, so he looks at him and he says, "Okay, this is how the curse will work. If you're telling me a lie, and you do actually have a skeleton and you can actually walk, then with my curse, you will lose your skeleton and you will hobble like this for the rest of your life. But if you were telling the truth and you are actually born without any bones, then you will develop a skeleton and you will be able to walk on your two feet." And of course, this is how young Bhagirath, because that was the name of that particular young boy, young Bhagirath then acquires his skeleton, and he's able to stand on his two feet. And as you will find, if you go off and find some more stories about young Prince Bhagirath, he went on to do some pretty amazing things, some pretty amazing adventures with his life afterwards. Now, to me, there's a very deep philosophical message attached to this story. I don't know what you take away from this story, but I would like to hear from you on what you think. Write to me.